Hello there, I'm Josh from the File Heaven, and today we are doing a review on the Hagerman Tuba Amplifier. So this is the first impressions slash unboxing video of the Hagerman Tuba Amplifier, designed by Jim Hagerman from Honolulu in Hawaii. This is a one-man company designed by a true pioneer in the audio industry who has designed a lot of interesting products, including this latest product, which is the first in a long time. So I will be doing the unboxing first, so to take the things out of the package, then I will be showing you what everything is and how it goes into place. So what you get in the package is first the little booklet. One thing that you may not know about them is that about the Hagerman Tuba amplifier is that it comes with 10 years of warranty. This is one of the longest warranties in the audio industry. I think this is the only product that has 10 years of warranty. So there is this little booklet, which has a lot of information about the circuits implemented in the Hagerman Tuba amplifier. Those are the specifications of it. And you can find a few diagrams of its circuits here. Now it comes with a little power brick, as you can see here. This is the power brick. Mine isn't the correct voltage for it isn't the correct shape for mine. It is the correct voltage, so I have to use a little power adapter to use it. I think this is a very good occasion to dust off the Eefy iPower I have somewhere in this room. And it also comes with two tubes and a little screwdriver. Now, the two tubes are Mullard LE84 tubes. They look like this. And there is a little screwdriver included in the package as well, which can act like as a pen, like which you can hold here, right? Like, I don't know why we would do this with a screwdriver, but it has this little part so that you can like do this with it. I don't know. It doesn't work very well, I think. So yeah, it is not such a good idea because it kind of points into your neck, and it would make a very complex suicidal mechanism, but I don't think it is all that good. Now, it comes in two Mullard LE84 tubes, and they look like this. Those are smaller tubes, not quite as big as the ones found on Felix Euphoria. Those are the tubes with this kind of socket. I will have to unbox both of them to show you the full might of the amplifier. And here is the amplifier, which is pretty heavy. This is the back of the amplifier, and this is the front of the amplifier. As you can see, the build quality kind of does some noise if you push it. So this is something to take into account when you use it. It has the two tube sockets on the top. It also has two headphone outputs, one in low gain and one in high gain on the front. It has a volume wheel which clicks in place. The volume wheel has a bit of wiggle, something to consider when purchasing a tube amplifier. That is normal. The wiggle on the volume potentiometer is normal. This is how you put the tubes into place. I'm sorry, I thought that my camera was in focus with me doing that. So this is the amplifier with the two tubes connected. They look like two antennas, little, very tiny antennas. Now, it is very easy to turn around the volume, which isn't exactly something I enjoy. On the other hand, it works very well with both EMs and headphones, although it cannot drive very hard to drive headphones like Hifiman HA6 SA or even Hifiman Aria. It doesn't have quite enough power for them. It has enough power for most easier to drive, even planar magnetic headphones. It has good control, so it doesn't distort with very low impedance headphones like Verum One, it can also drive high-end EMs, which is something that you probably won't be getting a full-sized amplifier for. It doesn't have a line out, which I think may have been nice if you wanted to use it as a full-sized system pre-amplifier. On the other hand, this has two outputs, which is something nice. It takes in 15 volts. This is a 15 volts device, not a 12. On the other hand, it is pretty heavy. You can see the power transformers on the inside. Those are very heavy and it ends up being a pretty heavy unit overall. I think that it sounds very gentle. It has a kick for subtlety in music. It really shows the fine subtleties in your music. It is very good at pointing out the finer details. It is very detailed, very clear and very crisp. It has a very, very crisp kind of sound. It is pretty neutral overall. It doesn't have a certain coloration to it. It has a very good amount of soundstage. It is pretty holographic. The two Mullard tubes used in it are very high quality. It gets very hot during usage. It burns like the sun. You should never touch the tubes of a tube amplifier while it is in usage. They can burn the skin off your fingers. It is something to take into account when taking one of those. Do not touch those. Do not touch the lamps while it is in usage. The lamps are very high quality. You can see that. I think that this concludes my first impressions and unboxing video of this little tube amplifier. I thank you for watching. I hope you'll consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Like this video if you liked it. Dislike if you didn't like this video. I hope you have a lovely weekend and I hope to see you soon. Bye bye.